Hello there guys, welcome to Dino's World. I am super excited to present kind of an India exclusive first review of the RTR 164V special edition that has been launched for 2023. And let me just get off the bike. Looks absolutely stunning in the white attire, doesn't it? And it does remind us of the Draken concept to a great extent. Checkered flag graphics, really awesome feel, and super fit and finish, and great build quality comes to standard when the branding reads TVS. This reminds us, or brings us a nostalgic feeling of the Draken concept once it premiered back in the Auto Expo. It was in white, and so is this one. So it really comes close to the concept avatar. But then it has come a long way. We had the 2V, then the 4V, and the 4V upgrade. So this one is the new 2023 model. We are going to see what all new features it gets. So first and the most important thing update is I'm going to give you a hint. Okay, try to read my lips. Woof woof. So Dino bhai, kya ho gaya? Kutta kaat liya kya? Nahi. So this one is the bullpup exhaust, and earlier we had the double barrel exhaust. So if you can come and close, at least show what the design has come up to now. So this is a single barrel exhaust, but it is kind of a pulse cannon kind of a design. Looks pretty massive, but the way it sounds is something you gotta listen. So let me just try and okay, are you ready? You gotta listen to that bass heavy exhaust note. Okay. Wow. Guess who revved the exhaust? The cameraman himself. But anyway, now we're having our share of fun in this pleasant evening right here in Hyderabad. So they are celebrating 4.8 million Apaches on road. That is a stupendous figure, and that's the kind of following the Apache tribe has here. So let's slowly go over the design elements and other things that have changed. Just as I hold on to the levers, these are the brake and the clutch levers, now come with adjustability. So this is another update that it gets. Another update it got earlier this year was the DRL. It feels like the teeth of predator or a animal that's ready to pounce on its prey. So that's a new design element that got updated earlier this year. You have the smart X connect feature, which means it comes with Bluetooth connectivity, call and SMS alerts, but it doesn't get navigation. Navigation is saved for the 200 4V. And then of course the design elements like the accents on the front fender, the scoops for the front suspension, prevents the dust from accumulating here. Then the rim stickers look super kick-ass. So all this highlights the racing DNA that underscores the bloodline of the RTR. Then of course the checkered flag graphics, the GT stripe right over here looks flawlessly made and super premium. Also the red accents extend all the way to the seat. Now this is for a proper bike enthusiast who has just married, has to find a bike that can fit the bill for his family, at the same time satiate the appetite for his speed. So a nice amount of space for the rider, good amount of space for the pillion. Even the ladies can access the seat pretty easily, and this is clearly inspired by Batman. You can see the grab rails, maybe these are made of aluminium, but the grab rail design, clearly Batman is evident right through that. Then Remora tires, 130 section tire at the back, 90 section tire up front, 17 inch wheels. These are specially developed tires to offer superior road grip even on wet surfaces. And the bullpup exhaust of course is the star of the show. You gotta listen to it absolutely roar as I ring the throttle wide open. Then talking about the engine, 160cc single cylinder fuel injected SOHC engine that puts out 17.55 PS of max power and 14.73 Newton meters of max torque. Still 5-speed gearbox. I wonder why they are not giving the 6th gear. Please TVS, answer our prayers, give us the 6th gear and we'll be attaining Nirvana by then. But anyway, jokes apart, let's hope that is saved for the fared version. I'm really hoping that we get a fared version of this, because that is going to be super capable and take on the likes of the R15 head on, because that is what this motor is capable of. So let me just turn on the speedo console. This is the speedo animation. Riding safety emphasized right over there. As it says, gear up.
You have engine kill switch right over here. Riding modes are again included even in the 160 now. So you have urban, rain and sport mode. Sport mode is the no holds barred mode where the beast is unleashed in all its splendid glory. Rain mode, power is little curtailed just to make sure that the bike doesn't skid on wet surfaces. In the urban mode, it is kind of best of both worlds. So it offers good initial pickup to perform those quick overtakes in the city. But when it comes to top speed is slightly curtailed. So that's pretty much it. This is an overview. Now let's hit the road, and that's where the magic is. That's where the bullpup exhaust roars like a lion more than a puppy. So you're gonna hear that roar and you're gonna be satisfied really with the BGM that is truly owned by the Apache tribe. So let's hit the road now. So guys, now that I've given you a quick overview of the new RTR 164V 2023 special edition model, they're celebrating 4.8 million Apaches on the road. This one gets adjustable levers, riding modes and whatnot, and Smart X Connect. So it's in the sport mode already. Let's, and it gets a new exhaust. That's the best part, the bullpup exhaust. Did you hear it? So damn satisfying. Gone is the double barrel exhaust. This one is 1 kg lighter. Power is 17.55 PS. Torque is 14.73 Newton meters. But the best background score that you can hear from 160cc bike here in India. What a sound! Absolutely awesome! Racing DNA is unleashed! Ooh la la. Ah, that was awesome, man. But it's the exhaust. Ooh, the downshifts. You bet, this is undeniably the best sound you can get from a 160cc bike here in India. The bullpup exhaust, woof woof, is loud and clear. Man, they made a crucial update. You got the DRL, you got the styling inspired from the Draken concept. Then you have adjustable levers now, Smart X Connect with the Bluetooth connectivity for call and SMS alert. Oh, Jupiter gives us a flyby, that's interesting. But anyway, let's keep our cool now. So the Bluetooth connectivity is not for navigation. Its navigation is available only in the 200, I believe. Here you have only call and SMS alert. And then of course you have single channel ABS, which they call Super Moto ABS, which means ABS is available only on the front wheel. Now the braking technique, going by that, you always are supposed to put around 75 to 80% pressure on the front brake and only 20-25% pressure on the rear brake. That's what experts maintain. So going by that philosophy, having a single channel ABS suffices. What a sound, man. It's an absolute beast. Reminds us of the Draken in the white attire. Bah. Mind-blowing sound, man. These guys are into sound engineering or what? I mean, every time Apache has always been known for an amazing background score, amazing exhaust sound. Brilliant, and what a beautiful evening here in Hyderabad. You bet, perfect weather to ride. Night black handlebar, flat bar handlebar, you don't get clip-ons, but still this serves the purpose. Nice vivid display, it's not color display, but still it is does serve the purpose. And you have different riding modes. We've been riding in sport all along. Then you have rain. Rain also offers good initial torque but cuts down on the top speed. And then you have urban, which is again offering good initial pickup to perform those quick overtakes in city limits, but the top end power is slightly reduced. But sport mode is the beast mode unleashed. Why not sixth gear, man? I mean, the bike has so much potential, but I know 160cc single cylinder fuel injected SOHC layout. So as I told you, 17.55 PS and 14.73 Newton meters, 5-speed gearbox. How I wish it was a 6-speed gearbox, but then maybe it's coming soon with a fared version. Let's hope for that. I've been rooting for that all along. I mean, TVS are known for the racing DNA, and why not? I've seen the RTR 160 fared one in the INMRC racing championship, and if only they can come up with a production variant, that would absolutely kill the game and kind of give serious run for the money for the likes of R15. Okay, so where are we? The exhaust sound is great, ergonomics are perfect, seat is nice and comfortable, you have this red accents, red stitching, suspension is well sorted, single channel ABS, pedal discs, so it's all a good package put together, and reasonable pricing for the kind of equipment you get. But the exhaust sound is something to die for, man. Achieved high speed. that's something it shows here. Okay, gotta ride responsibly now. So that's pretty much it. This was a quick fire run of the 2023 special edition Apache RTR 164V. If you like what you see and want to see more pure automobile content coming your way, feel free to stay subscribed for more action coming up right here at Dino's Vault. This one is the star of the show, the bullpup exhaust.